Hello and welcome back after your summer break. Hopefully you had a good time and enjoyed yourself. I must say I caught up with some great quality family time. We were in Hawaii where the weather for the most part was actually pretty good, and also had some lovely time back in New Zealand where there was a real heat wave when I returned to New Zealand, followed I guess by that rain that we saw in Australia, and of course our hearts that lost loved ones in those terrible floods in Australia. New Zealand's been working hard to try and help our friends across the ditch, and of course Queensland were extremely supportive of New Zealand when we had the Pike River disaster late last year, so it was good to try and be able to reciprocate and help our friends. And I think we realised the significance of the relationship between New Zealand and Australia when each of the countries faces its own challenges and adversities and manages to help each other out through some very difficult times. This year, 2011, is election year, of course, and today I gave arguably State of the Nation speech, but at least an economic speech facing the big challenges for our country and the solutions that the National-led government intends to propose. As you know, when we came into office, it was a very difficult time actually for the government. New Zealand had been in recession for all of 2008. Inflation was running at around about 5%. And when we opened the books as an incoming government, the predictions from Treasury were that we would have never-ending deficits and escalating debt, spiralling out of control unless we took some action. So in the first budget of 2009, as well as trying to help people through the economic difficulties of the time and through the recession, we also got on top of our spending and started to pare back that big increase in debt. 2010's budget focused very, very heavily on the economic tax switches that we wanted to put in place. They were about making sure that New Zealanders had more money, but mainly about making sure that New Zealanders had more choice, so they could decide whether they wanted to pay off their mortgage or save or spend, whatever it might be. And so that was the reason we cut personal taxes to become more competitive with other countries around the world and had a modest increase in GST. We also put a lot of integrity back in the tax system. Once you break that alignment between the top personal rate and the trust rate, then you leave yourself open for enormous financial planning. And we saw that with a lot of New Zealanders who really should be paying the top personal rate actually using financial engineering to avoid that. So we made clear today in the speech that Budget 2011 focus will be on investment and savings. And the reason for that is that if you look at the structural issues that the New Zealand economy faces, those issues are quite clear and apparent, and they are an over-reliance on borrowing from foreigners. So no OECD country, no developed country, owes more of its debt to foreigners as a percentage of that debt than New Zealand. And that means if those foreigners one day decide that New Zealand isn't as attractive destination to lend money, we could face a real crisis in terms of our ability to fund not only our public sector debt, which comes from government spending, but also private sector debt, which funds your home or business. So that's a situation we can't afford to occur. The second point we made in this speech is that if we look at countries that have a debt profile like New Zealand, we owe around about 85% of GDP, then we see some company that we wouldn't want to be in. Ireland, Spain, Greece, Portugal, they are the sorts of countries that have the type of profile that New Zealand has. And we know what's happened to those countries. They've faced a severe debt crisis, and in either they've face more and increasing costs for raising their debt in the case of a country like Spain. So that means you as a homeowner or you as a business owner pay more and higher interest rates because we are theoretically a less credit worthy country. Or alternatively, you simply can't borrow that money easily. That was the case of Ireland, and they need to bail out from the European Union. So that's the issue around debt. And the second real part of that equation is that as a country, we're simply not saving enough. So we want to own more of our own future. We want to maximise those opportunities. And it's about putting those two things together, getting on top of our debt position, making sure that we're not vulnerable, making sure that your interest rates stay low, but also making sure that we can fund those opportunities. So why is that important? Well, we want a high growth economy. We want you to be able to have jobs which pay you well, that retain your services here in our economy. There's no point in New Zealand educating very bright people and then just simply exporting them to Australia or other parts of the world. So what we've made clear is we're going to be more conservative this year in terms of our operating expenditure. That's the amount of money that we spend every day in terms of running the country. Now, a lot of that is already accounted for, if you like, but each year in the budget process, the government gets the opportunity to modestly increase that, if you like, and spend a bit more. In the last 5 years of the previous Labor government, on average, they increased that just under $3 billion a year. We've been running that at around about $1.1 billion. So you can see how conservative we've already been. And that's one of the tools we use to bring the books back into surplus earlier than had been predicted by the Treasury. We've now decided that number will be around about $800 to $900 million. So you can see, relative to the $3 billion, we're running a very tight, if you like, spending program, and that's requiring us to get rid of waste in the government. It's requiring us to reprioritise spending and to be very conservative with your taxpayer dollars, and I think you'll welcome that. Second area where we spend money is what's called capital investment. So just like you, when you buy a home or a car or whatever it might be that you treat as a capital item, we spend a lot of money in that area as well. And what we've decided is that we are more than likely to apply a model called the mixed ownership model to an increasing number of state-owned assets. So that means the model that Air New Zealand runs, where a percentage is owned by the government and a percentage is owned by maybe you as a shareholder, is a mixed model, as opposed to, say, let's take a retailer like, for instance, Genesis, an electricity producer, that's 100% owned by the government. So what is the advantages of that? Well, it allows us to release that capital. So by selling you some shares, we take that capital out of that company, and we can then apply that to areas where we want to grow the economy. So put it into areas where we see real growth opportunities for New Zealand, or to borrow less. So both of those things help us in terms of taking pressure off our demand to borrow. That means that the rating agencies, Standard & Poor's in particular, who put us on negative outlook, because they were concerned about our debt levels, will see that the government is acting. And that's, I think, an interesting opportunity. This speech, I'd encourage you to have a look at, lays out all of the tests, but I can assure you that majority control of those assets would be held by New Zealanders. New Zealand investors, and particularly mums and dads, would be at the forefront of that investment program. But have a look at the speech and you'll see what we're talking about. But in the end, it's about reducing the amount of debt that we owe and the amount of borrowing that we need to complete, and about increasing the savings pool and therefore the investment opportunities for New Zealanders and for New Zealand as a country. We are taking a very serious perspective, if you like, on New Zealand's economic future. And the reason for that is we think the next 10 to 20 years can be a very powerful time for New Zealand. Demographic trends are very strong. Asia is growing very rapidly. There are huge opportunities for our goods and services. They're demanding a lot of the food and high-tech services we produce. So we've got to be a government that delivers that platform for growth. And that means low interest rates. It means a competitive exchange rate. It means a government that's on top of its expenditure. And it means a plan for New Zealand, and I think you saw in today's speech the first elements of that new plan that we're taking into the election in 2011. So look forward to many more blogs. There's a great many of you now following me either on Facebook or Twitter. Over 50,000 of you are fans, or 5,000 maxed out as friends. It's great to have you there. We also encourage you to look at all of the other things we do electronically. It's increasingly an important way that we want to communicate with you, particularly in the election year. And we thank you for your support and interest in the National Lead Government.